Well, now it's my pleasure to introduce my central banking colleagues to say a few words each before we turn to a question and answer panel. And let me invite Agustin Carstens, Governor of the Bank of Mexico, to talk to us. Agustin.
Thank you. Well, good morning. It's a pleasure to be here at this event. I thank Mervyn very much and the UK government for having invited me to this splendid event at this obviously very exciting time here in the UK. Coming from Mexico, certainly I think the most value added I can provide is also put Mexico into perspective. Needless to say, we are facing in the world very difficult times, and I think it would be too presumptuous to say that there is a possibility of decoupling or of a single country not to being affected by the major difficulties that advanced economies are facing. Some countries, needless to say, are doing better than others, and I am relieved to say that Mexico is in the group where we are doing quite above average in different dimensions. We have a fast-growing economy, we have financial stability, investment is thriving, and I think that we can look with a relative optimism into the future. Now, it's important to put in perspective why we are in this situation. I think that a very important event that happened just around 15, 16 years ago is that we as a country realized that it is important to pursue permanent financial stability. And today we're seeing that pursuing financial stability on a permanent basis pays and pays well. Mexico was a crisis-prone economy. I would like to remember you that in the 70s, 80s, and 90s, there were 9 countries in Latin America with 3 major financial crises in that period of time. That is quite a record. And of course, the topic, the label called Lost Decade, was coined for Latin America. And I think we learned our lesson, and therefore, at least in Mexico, and I can talk also about many other countries, certainly Brazil is one of them, we really have invested in preserving macro stability. I think for our case, there have been 4 key issues to put us in this position. One is to be very conservative on fiscal policy. Mexico has today a debt to GDP ratio of 30%. We are having operating since 2005 on a balanced budget rule. I would say that Mexico was probably one, if not the only country in the G20 that in 2009 we didn't fall into the call of the IMF to expand fiscal policy, and we did a value-added tax reform. And I think that has paid off very well. In 94, at the time of our last crisis, the average maturity of Mexican debt was less than 6 months. Today, the average maturity of Mexican debt is 7 years, and is far above the average maturity of US debt, which is also quite an accomplishment from the way I see it. We also have a very strong banking system. We had a banking sector crisis in 94. We have learned our lesson. We have speed up reforms. We have speed up the adoption of best practices in regulation. Mexico probably will be the first country that will be fully Basel III compliant this year. And as much as Basel III is known, because there are still some issues that they need to be finalized in terms of regulation. I would say now that we are in an Olympic environment, Mexico would have, Mexico's banking system certainly would be in the medalist group. So I think that we feel very proud about it, even though we have a strong foreign bank presence. The subsidiary principle works quite well for us. I think another key element have been that we have moved already since 1994 to a flexible exchange rate regime coupled with an autonomous central bank. And I think that this has allowed us to have sufficient flexibility in the real exchange rate to accommodate external shocks, at the same time preserving financial stability and price stability. And I think that this is one of the keys why Mexico's growth has averaged over 4% in the last three years, which I think is also very good. And our last point is that, my last point is that we also have been pursuing structural reforms. To be competitive at the end of the day, you need to have a very competitive economy. You have to work on the real sectors that determine growth. Many issues, as were addressed by Prime Minister Cameron, have also been done in Mexico. We still have a long way to go. I think Mexico easily could be growing at an average rate of 6 to 7%. But we have already clearly defined agenda, and we will work in this regard in the coming years. So the message, I think, is clear, how to overcome many of these problems. For example, in Europe, I would say the message coming from Mexico could be a positive message. If you sit down and do your work and pursue stability with patience, you will get there, and it will pay off. Thank you very much.